Hello and welcome, fellow Wasteland Survivors. I'm Dean, and I've got a question for you. Do you love building in Fallout 76? Yeah, so do I. When you're finished with your masterpiece, and it's time to wire it, does it kind of turn out to look something like this? And when you're finished with your electrical, you're just not as happy with your camp as you was before you started to put in the electrical? Well, don't feel alone. Quite a few of us struggle with the electrical in 76. But in today's video, we're going to be seeing some tips and tricks on how you can hide the electrical conduit connectors and the wires inside of your walls. These tips will keep your camp super clean and looking its best. Plus, your friends will be so jealous as they look around and wonder in amazement on how you did this. In today's video, we're going to be using a wire glitch quite a bit throughout the build, so we need to take a few minutes to fully understand how this wire glitch works. Now, it's not really a glitch, it's more of an exploit. We're just going to call it the wire glitch. Some of you may already know how to do this, but I'm sure there are a lot of people who don't, so this will help us better understand how it works. We're going to do it with four different objects: this electrical conduit pipe, a rug, a foundation, and the wall. Now, the concept of how this glitch works is pretty easy to understand, but quite often it's a lot harder to do than you might think. What we'll do is do the carpet first. We'll connect it up to an electrical conduit connector. We'll move the carpet once, and now the carpet, or the wire, is now glitched, and it'll go through any object that we want it to go through. The way that this actually works is once you've connected the wire, you have to move the object to another point or area that the wire will still be connected. So we'll move the conduit just a little bit. The wire's still connected. Now we can move it anywhere we want to. Like I said, the concept of this is pretty easy to understand, but a lot of times, especially if you're doing it with walls, it's a little harder to do than you might think. There's a lot of snapping and a lot of build order. All right, now let's go ahead and do our foundation. All we have to do is just move the foundation a little bit, and as long as the wire is still connected, we are now glitched, and we can snap this foundation anywhere we want to. But it cannot snap through a wire. As you can see, the foundation we're moving has a ghost foundation left behind, and the wire is still connected. That will not allow us to snap that conduit or that foundation onto the foundation that the wire was in the way. Here we got the foundation snapped up here and the wires going through the foundation. Once again, you cannot snap this because that ghost wire or ghost object is still there. So what you have to do is move it out of the way somewhere where the wire is not in the way, and then you'll be able to snap it back up or place the object where you'd like it to be. Now, where you might run into a lot of problems doing this is with walls, because walls actually have to be snapped to a support, which is generally a foundation, but you could snap them to floors as well. We've seen that in other tips and tricks in this series. Alright, so what I normally do is put a foundation somewhere out of the way where it's easy to snap the wall into two different spots. The first spot is where we're going to connect the wire up to begin with. Now we can move the wall to another snap point, and as long as the wire is still connected and it's not broken, this is now glitched, and we can take it over to another foundation or wherever your build is at, and that wire is now going through any object that you need it to go through. Alright, let's get started with the main part of this video on how to hide these objects in the walls. We're going to do it two different ways. First, we're going to start with foundations, and then later on in the video, we're going to do it with the floors. I've got a 3x3 foundation built, and I've colored the floors in the corners because that's where the electrical conduits are going to be. I've already aligned up all of the conduits except for this one so that you can see how it needs to kind of be placed here. What you want to do is line it up in a way in the corner that the wall would cover the conduit the best that you can. So it's not sticking out in the back or in the front too much. Since this is a corner, we need to do it in both directions or both sides of the foundation. Now we'll bring one of the foundations over. We'll call this one Foundation 2 or Connection 2. Now you can snap it if you would like, but it's going to be easier if it's not snapped. That way we can just move it a little bit. We'll take foundation number 3 out, we'll place it beside the foundation 2, and then we'll take out foundation 4 and place it in there as well. Now that we've got our foundations over here, all we need to do is connect up our wires. So we'll connect foundation 1 to foundation 2, foundation 2 to foundation 3, and foundation 3 to foundation 4. We've got all of our wires connected. Now it's time to glitch the wire. We'll take our second foundation, move it a little bit. Our third foundation, we'll just move it a little bit as well. Our fourth foundation, once again, will move a little, and we also will want to move foundation 1 just to make sure that it's glitched. So we'll move the second foundation out of the way a little bit, and we'll spin it because it is snapped in. As long as the wire did not break, then now foundation 1 is glitched. All we have to do is bring our other foundations in and place them back where they go. It's pretty simple, it's pretty easy to do with the foundations because they will set on the ground and they don't have to be snapped to support. And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, we have now glitched all of our wiring on our foundations. And you can see the wires going through the floors to the other conduit connectors and back to our first foundation. Alright, now let's put in some walls. Now we can only snap walls onto foundations that don't have any wires or wire connectors attached to them. You cannot snap a wall over top or into those objects. Also, we've added in a ceiling. Now if you're building a multi-story build, you can use floors to do the same thing that we're going to use these roofs for. And that is to snap walls up to, because we're going to be moving our foundations back and out of the way again. Because we can't snap the walls over top of these objects, we have to move them out of the way. And we need to place them out somewhere where the wires are not in the way, so that way we can snap these foundations back in after we've placed the walls up. Now, once again, the reason the ceilings are up, or a floor if you chose to use that, was so that we had a way to snap walls back into the corners where these foundations were at. Also, I'm using different types of walls. We've got the metal wall, the concrete wall, the barn wall, and the warehouse walls. This way you guys and gals can see that it doesn't matter what type of wall you're using, it still works the same way. Now let's bring foundation number 1 in and snap it back into place. And there you go, you can see that the conduit and the wire is now inside of the wall. Let's grab foundation number 4 and we'll snap that one in too. All of these walls work exceptionally well with doing this, with the exception of the concrete wall. Because the concrete wall is not a frame, it's more kind of solid, the conduit will not allow you to snap it into place. And as you can see there with foundation 3, it was red and it wouldn't let us put it in. Here's foundation number 2 showing the same thing. Well, this is how we get around that. We're going to change the variance of the concrete wall into a door. Once we do that, then it allows it to snap right into place. Now, if you're having problems with your other walls, then change those into doors as well. But all the times I've done this, I've never had any problem snapping these into any of the other walls other than the concrete walls. Once we got them in, you can see that it's now inside of the wall and the wires are still running through the wall. All we have to do now is change our doors back into walls, and you have a solid build with your wiring going through everything. Also, if you chose to have a doorway in, you can see the wire is not showing in the doorway. And we'll just change our concrete walls real quick back to regular walls, and voila! We have wiring running through everything and we can't see it. Now all you have to do is put up your wallpaper. Alright, now let's take a look at how to do this using floors. Now keep this in mind, it's basically the same way that we did with the foundations. The difference is floors need support. We can't actually just set them down anywhere that we want. So it's a little bit more complicated moving the floors around so that they have support to other floors that they might have been attached to. We're going to move our conduit out to the corner of the floor just like we did down on the lower foundation, and we're going to attach it to power. Now we're going to bring our second floor over so that way we can glitch the wire. And it's still supported out there because of the floor that we're standing on. Now we're going to move the floor over in a way that we can actually spin it without the wire breaking. So we'll attach our wire and now we'll spin the floor. As long as the wire didn't break, it's now glitched. If it broke, then you're going to have to try it again in another position. We'll put our floor back and now it's glitched. But we want to make sure that our floor number 1 is glitched. So we have to spin it one time. But now if you notice, the wire's going through the floor. So we've got to move it out into a spot where the wire's not in the way so that we can put it back in the same position, or the correct position. And we're just going to do the same thing with all 4 floors all the way around. And once we put floor number 4 in, we can see our wires coming from our generator to floor 1, over to 2, 3, and over to floor number 4. Alright, let's add in some walls. Earlier in this video, I did say that you can't snap a wall over top of these conduits and wires, but there is actually a way that you can do it. It's a little bit more complicated, but every now and then a circumstance will arise that you'll have to do this. So that's why we're going to go ahead and show it. What you need to do is bring your first floor over and snap it in a way that the wires are going directly out of the build. It doesn't work if the wires are coming into the build or down the length of the wall. We can snap both walls in at this point. And there you go, you can see just how easy they did snap in. Now we'll change the variance of this wall to a door so that we can target floor number 2 and move it back to where it needs to be. We can change the variance of the door back to a wall, and there you go. We've actually snapped a wall in without using a roof or a floor. Now for floor number 2, it's going to get a little bit more complicated, and we're going to have to do a few more steps. First thing that we're going to want to do is put a couple of roofs up or a floor so that we can create a support point for floor number one. It's the only way that we can take that floor out and the walls stay supported. Now our wire is going out of the build and we can snap our next wall in. Once we've done that, we can change the wall over to a door, so that way we can grab floor number one and put it back where it's supposed to go. And there we go. We've actually placed these wires or these walls in without using roofs, or somewhat without using roofs. Now we can bring floor number three over and do the same thing. Now, quite often, by doing this, you can actually snap the concrete wall in without changing it to a door. But if you do have problems, remember, just change it to a door and you won't have a problem. So we changed it to a door so that way we could target floor number three and put it back where it needs to go. Now we've changed our walls back and we're ready to do floor number three. But what we're going to need to do to create support for floor number two is move our two ceilings over to that part of the build. Once again, we're doing this so that we create a support or a anchor point for our walls so that we can move the floor out from underneath of it. Once we've done that, we're just going to repeat the process and snap our walls back in. We're going to make a door in the concrete so that we can put floor number two back. And as you can see, look at there. It won't go back in this time. The reason is because the wire's going down the wall. So we'll change that wall into a door. And now we can go ahead and put the floor back in to where it's supposed to go. It's a little bit complicated, like I said. It's got a few extra moves that you have to do, but it can be done, and you don't need all those extra roofs or ceilings or floors in up above to get this done. And this is a great example of how to put these items in without using roofs to do it. They're just snapping right into the floors, and this works with the concrete foundations down below as well. Alright, now even though we're at the end and all we have to do is one wall, we still got to do a support for floor number three. Also, because we're going to have problems putting the floor back in, we're going to leave the concrete wall as a door so that way we just don't have any problems when we go to snap it back in. Now, if you notice, it was snapped in there a little bit weird, so we had to spin it around. If those two conduits are side by side, you're not going to be able to get it in. So make sure that the wire's running out of the build or out away from the wall. Once again, it doesn't work if the wire's coming inside or down the length of the wall. Once we've got all of our floors done, we can go ahead and change all of our walls to whatever variance that you want it to be. And we're just going to make them all walls again. Now, also keep this in mind, ladies and gentlemen, you could actually add in your roof at this time, just like we did down on the foundation. And then you wouldn't have had to have moved the two roofs around as you went around the build. Also keep this in mind, your build may be longer or bigger than just three floors, and all you do is just repeat the same processes that we've been doing down the entire length of your build, however many floors or walls it may be. And now let's take a look at it from outside so we can see just how nice this looks. We can't see any of the electrical conduits or the wiring anywhere. Also, by using just these four little electrical conduits, we can add lighting in anywhere we want to, from the foundation up to three stories tall. All right, now I've got one more tip I'd like to show before we end the video. If you're like me, It's pretty frustrating to come back to your camp and see your fusion core generator blown up. Well, the tip I'd like to show is how you can hide it in concrete foundations. Then those NPCs can't get to it. Now, there's a couple of things you need to know before you can get this to work. First thing is, a concrete foundation or any foundation will only stick up out of the ground so far. It's about half the height of the foundation, and that's not tall enough to cover the entire generator. So you're gonna need something to support the foundation on so that you can lift it up higher, like a slope, a cliff, or something like this concrete pillar that's holding up this tower. Now we're able to lift the foundation up high enough that it would go over top of the generator. Now we're going to bring the generator in and place it on the side. We cannot actually place a foundation directly over the top of the generator. So we're going to use this foundation we're moving right now as a support foundation. But we're going to place it in a way that we can snap another foundation in on that concrete pillar, and then that would become the foundation or the support for it. All right, I hope that made sense. Now we need to move the generator back until it's about halfway in the center of the foundation. And I don't think we're quite far enough, so we're going to move it back to the left a little bit farther. Also, we're going to lift the foundation up a little bit more, so that way we're covering plenty of the top of the generator. Also, if you notice, side to side, it's about half or in the middle of what a foundation would be. Now we're able to snap two other foundations right over the top of it. Now this will only work if your generator is in the center of the foundations. Also, because of the way we've done this, this foundation we're standing on is now supported by the concrete pillar that's holding up the tower, and we can take the first foundation away. If this is done correctly, it only takes two foundations to cover your generator. Also, if you noticed, we couldn't actually target the generator, which is perfect, because if you can't target it, neither can the NPCs. So, because of that, we have to bring our floor that we had connected to the generator throughout the video over and attach the wire from the conduit on the floor to the generator. You cannot attach a wire from the generator to the conduit because you can't target it. Also, don't forget to move your floor one time so that the wire doesn't break, and that way it glitches the wire. And there we go. We now have a fully 100% protected generator that the NPCs can no longer destroy. All right, everybody, thank you all very much for stopping in and hanging out with me today. I really do appreciate it. I hope these tips and tricks gave you some great ideas on things that you can do in your build. And just like always, until next time, please stay safe and peace.